Hello everyone, in this session I will be dealing with the topic spatial multiplexing, which allows the transmission and reception of multiple data streams in a multiple antenna system. So basically spatial multiplexing refers to breaking the incoming high rate data stream into m parallel data streams for m equal to nt and nt less than or equal to nr. Here m denotes total number of parallel data streams, nt is the number of transmit antenna, and nr is the total number of receive antennas. So here in spatial multiplexing, it transmits multiple substreams to increase the data rate. So a spatial multiplexing MIMO system, that means multiple input, multiple output system or multiple antenna system, it transmits multiple substreams to increase the data rate. That means high rate data stream, it is divided into m parallel data streams. Then you can transmit those low data rate streams using multiple antennas. Thus you can increase the overall data rate of the system. This shows the block diagram representation of a spatial multiplexing MIMO system with NT number of transmit antennas and NR number of receive antennas. So as you can see here, high rate data stream is given as input to the serial to parallel converter, and then using this serial to parallel converter, it is divided into m number of parallel data streams. Then using antennas, these data streams are simultaneously transmitted, and at the receiver section, using nr number of receive antennas, that received data, it is applied to the parallel to serial converter, and then this parallel data stream is converted into serial data, and then it is given to the next stage for further processing. And here capital H, it refers the channel matrix, and its dimension is nr cross nt. And here the overall data rate is given by the equation r into minimum of nt comma nr, where r is the rate per individual stream. So in spatial multiplexing, there is a spectral efficiency. So this spectral efficiency is increased by a factor of capital M, where M equal to NT, and this spectral efficiency is increased by using multiple antennas. That means adding antenna elements can greatly increase the data rate without any increase in the bandwidth. So we can achieve higher data rate without increasing the bandwidth, just by increasing the total number of elements, antenna elements in the system, we can increase the data rate. Next, let us consider a spatial multiplexing technique which is widely used in the MIMO system. So consider this case: if the transmitter and receiver both have multiple antennas, that means we have NT number of transmit antenna and NR number of receive antennas, then we can set up multiple parallel data streams between them. So we can set up m equal to nt number of parallel data streams between transmitter and receiver. So in a nt cross nr spatial multiplexing system, the maximum data rate or peak data rate is proportional to minimum of nt comma nr. So for this system, nt cross nr system, we can write a standard mathematical model or equation which represents this spatial multiplexing. So it is given by y equal to hx plus n. So here y is the received vector and its dimension is nr cross 1, and capital H is the channel matrix and its dimension is nr cross nt, and x is the transmit vector with dimension of nt cross 1, and noise vector size of n is nr cross 1. Next, let us see the channel matrix H. So as I told previously, the dimension of this matrix is NR cross NT. So this H11, H12, etc., this refers to channel gain parameter, complex channel gain parameter from transmitter to receiver. In general, HIJ, it refers the channel gain parameter from transmit antenna J to receive antenna I. That means here the first suffix I, it refers the receive antenna, and second suffix J, it refers the transmit antenna. Next, assume that the spatial channels all experience uncorrelated relay fading and Gaussian noise. That means here multiple channels that are available between transmitter and receiver are assumed to be uncorrelated. That means there is no correlation between those channel responses. And here relay fading channel is considered, and also it is assumed that there is a AWGN noise in the channel. And the transmit vector is normalized by NT. That means that vector X, it is normalized by NT, so that each symbol in X has average energy of EX by NT. So as I told previously, there are NT number of parallel channels available. Therefore, the energy of each symbol, it is reduced to EX by NT. So that overall energy will be EX. And we can compare this MIMO system performance with the single input, single output system with each symbol energy EX. Next, let us see what are the different types of spatial multiplexing methods. So in antenna diversity technique, we have discussed about open loop antenna diversity and closed loop antenna diversity. So similar to that, in the spatial multiplexing also, we can perform this multiplexing with or without channel knowledge at the transmitter. So depending on this, there are two classes of MIMO: open loop MIMO and closed loop MIMO. So in open loop MIMO, spatial multiplexing, it does not require the channel feedback. So channel knowledge is not required at the transmitter section. In the closed loop MIMO system, spatial multiplexing, it requires the channel feedback. Therefore, it is a spatial multiplexing with channel feedback. Let us discuss these two types one by one. Okay, first let us start with open loop MIMO. So in this open loop MIMO, it is assumed that the channel is known at the receiver. So this is maybe through pilot symbols or any other channel estimation techniques. So as I told previously, in this open loop MIMO technique, channel feedback is not required at the transmitter section. Also here we are making one more assumption that the channel is known at the receiver section. So this method, it attempts to suppress the interference that results from receiving NT number of data streams at the receive antennas. So there are NT number of parallel data streams, and this will be received using NR number of receive antennas. Definitely there will be interference, and many interference suppression methods are used at the receiver section. So based on this interference suppression techniques, there are many types of open loop MIMO receivers. They are maximum likelihood detection, linear detector, and blast. So here this blast means it is Bell Labs layered space time. So it is a type of spatial multiplexing receiver. So full form of this blast is Bell Labs layered space time. More about this we will discuss later. As I explained in the previous slide, three types of detectors are used in the open loop MIMO system. So the first type is optimum decoding. So here maximum likelihood detection method is used. So if the channel is unknown at the transmitter, the optimum decoder is the maximum likelihood decoder, or ML decoder. So in this method, it finds the most likely input vector X cap using minimum distance criterion. So that minimum distance criterion is given here. So x cap equal to argument of the minimum norm of y minus h into x square. So here y is the received vector, h is the channel matrix, and x is the transmit vector. So the minimum distance criterion to estimate the received symbol is x cap equal to argument of the minimum norm of y minus hx square. So this maps each coordinate to the closest constellation point, but the computational complexity of this system is very high even for a small number of antennas. So sometimes lower complexity approximation of ML detector is also used, and that lower complexity version is called as spear decoder, and it can be used to reduce the computational complexity. Okay, next, lower complexity approximation of the maximum likelihood detector, the spear decoder, it can be used to reduce the complexity. As I explained in the previous slide, the maximum likelihood detection, it requires large number of computation. For example, if you consider QPSK modulation, then order of modulation capital M equal to 4, and suppose there are two transmit antennas, that is NT is 2, then total number of possible input vector is M to the power NT, that means 4 raised to 2, that means there are 16 possible input vectors. So it becomes very complex. So instead of this, we can use lower complexity approximation of that maximum likelihood detector or the spear decoder. The next alternate approach, instead of this maximum likelihood detection, is a linear detector. So this is the second type of detector used in the open loop MIMO. The linear detector, such as a zero forcing detector, can be used to recover the transmitted vector x. So in this linear detector, it sets the receiver response equal to the inverse of the channel. So previously we have considered channel response as H. So H represents the channel matrix. So this linear detector, it sets the receiver response equal to the inverse of the channel. That means zero forcing response G suffix ZF equal to H inverse when NT equal to NR. So this is the response of the linear detector. Okay, next let us consider the block diagram representation of spatial multiplexing with a linear receiver. As you can see in the figure, the serial input data stream, it is converted into parallel lower data rate streams. So serial to parallel converter is used here. So the input data stream is converted into NT number of parallel data streams and then transmitted using antenna. And channel response is represented in terms of channel matrix H. At the receiver section, the received signal from the NR number of receive antenna is applied to the linear receiver, and response of that linear receiver is GZF, and this GZF equal to H inverse of the channel response. So previously we have considered the response of linear zero forcing detector as H inverse, but next let us consider the general case. So consider pseudo inverse. In that case, we can write response GZF equal to H star H inverse H star. So here this H refers to the channel matrix and star represents the complex conjugate. Therefore, the zero forcing detector, it completely removes the spatial interference from the transmitted signal, and we can write estimated received vector X cap equal to the product of zero forcing detector response and the received vector y. So GZF into y. Next, substitute for y equal to hx plus n. So in the next step, we can write it as GZF hx plus GZF into n. Then substitute for GZF. So we can write it as x plus h star h inverse into h star n. So here, as you can see here, the first term is x, which is nothing but the actual transmitted vector. Therefore, this particular detector, zero forcing detector, it removes all the spatial interference from the transmitted signal. But the problem is the bad spatial subchannels can severely amplify the noise in the noise vector. So as you can see here, n is multiplied by h star h inverse h star. Therefore, the bad spatial subchannel, it will severely amplify the noise. So this results in extremely poor performance. Therefore, the zero forcing detector is not practical for long term evolution or 4G system, because performance is very poor because of amplified noise. Therefore, the zero forcing detector, it is not practical for long term evolution or 4G system. So there is an alternative to the zero forcing receiver. It is called as minimum mean square error estimator receiver. So this MMSE receiver, it gives a balance between spatial interference suppression and noise enhancement by minimizing the distortion. So this is the alternate approach, and this MMSE receiver, it attempts to make a balance between spatial interference suppression and noise enhancement. And in this case, the response of the system, response of the linear MMSE receiver, it is given by G MMSE. This is equal to h star h plus sigma z square into I divided by pt inverse h star. So here sigma z square is the variance and I is the interference matrix and pt is the transmitted power. So this G MMSE is the response of the MMSE receiver. The next third type of detector used in the open loop MIMO system is the BLAST, BLAST, BLAST. So this is a spatial multiplexing receiver which was invented in Bell Labs. Therefore, it is named as BLAST, Bell Labs Layered Space Time. So this BLAST consists of parallel layers supporting multiple simultaneous data streams. And the layers in BLAST are separated by interference cancellation techniques. So these layers are also called as substreams. The two most important techniques that are used in the BLAST method are original diagonal BLAST, called as D-BLAST, and its subsequent version, vertical BLAST or V-BLAST. Okay, first consider diagonal BLAST or D-BLAST. This is the original scheme in BLAST family. Here, diagonally layered coding sequence is used. This groups the transmitted symbols into layers, which are then coded in time independently of the other layers. That means input data streams are divided to several substreams. Then substreams are coded independently. The number of code symbols equal to number of transmit antennas. So once sublayers are encoded, then they are sent to the different transmit antennas in a cyclical manner. This results in each layer being transmitted in a diagonal of space and time. Therefore, both space diversity and time diversity are achieved here. Therefore, the NT transmitted streams will equally share the good and bad spatial channels. Okay, next let us see how to decode the received signal in D-BLAST method. The diagonal layer structure of D-BLAST can be detected by decoding one layer at a time. That means it is layer by layer decoding method. The decoding process for the second of four layers is explained here. Four transmit antennas with four diagonal layers are considered and it is named as 1, 2, 3, 4. So here layer 1 is already been detected and 3 and 4 yet to be detected, and now we want to detect layer 2. So each layer is detected by nulling the layers that have not yet been detected and cancelling the layers that have already been detected. So here, since layer 1 is already detected, its contribution is subtracted from the received signal. Layer 3 and 4 are yet to be detected, therefore it will remain as interference and its contribution is nulled, and then decode and estimate layer 2. The drawback of this decoding is it is iterative and more complex. Also, this diagonal layering structure it wastes space time slots at the beginning and end of the D blast. As you can see here, these blocks are not utilized, therefore it is wasted. So this is the drawback. Okay, the second blast method is vertical blast or V blast. So this is somewhat simpler than the previously discussed diagonal blast. In diagonal blast, we need to use iterative decoding method, which is very complex. So to overcome the complexity and inefficiency associated with the D blast, we can go for vertical blast. So in V blast, each antenna simply transmits an independent symbol stream. So the high data rate input stream, it is divided into substreams, and then coded stream, it is transmitted using multiple antennas. So here there is no diagonalization of the data stream, and detection is done dynamically, and the layer with the highest signal to noise ratio, it is detected first. In the D blast method, it is layer by layer iterative decoding method, but here detection is done based on the signal to noise ratio. The layer with the highest signal to noise ratio, it is detected first. Okay, the space-time representation of V blast encoding scheme is given here. There are four transmit antennas, and it is numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4. And for decoding, the linear receivers such as zero forcing detector and minimum mean square estimator decoder or MMSC decoder can be used, and this will suppress the contribution from the NT-1 interfering data streams. So simultaneously NT data streams are transmitted. While decoding one substream, the effect of remaining NT-1 interfering data streams are suppressed using either zero forcing detector or MMSC detector. The post detection signal to noise ratio for the ith stream is given by gamma I equal to EX divided by sigma square into norm of WRI square. Here EX is the energy associated with the transmitted symbol, and sigma square is the noise variance, and gamma I is the signal to noise ratio after detection, and I varies from 1 to NT, where NT is the transmitted total number of transmit antennas. The V blast can use detector that combines a linear receiver with ordered successive interference cancellation. That means instead of detecting all NT streams in parallel, they are detected iteratively. So the previously discussed zero forcing detector and MMSC detector are the linear receivers, and we can combine those receivers with ordered successive interference cancellation. That means instead of detecting all streams in parallel, we can use iterative method. So here in the iterative method, first the strongest symbol stream is detected. After these symbols are detected, they can be subtracted from the composite received signal. Then the second strongest signal is detected, and now only NT-2 interfering streams are available, and in general the ith detected stream experience interference from only NT-I of the transmit antennas, so that by the time the weakest symbol stream is detected, the majority of spatial interference has been removed. So this successive interference cancellation lowers the block error rate by a factor of 10 relative to a linear receiver. Okay, so far we have discussed about open loop MIMO technique. The second method is the closed loop MIMO system or spatial multiplexing with channel feedback. Here, let us consider a simple theoretical example using singular value decomposition SVD that shows the potential gain of closed loop spatial multiplexing method. So, first let us consider this singular value decomposition method, which helps us to understand the importance of closed loop MIMO system and advantages and gain of this transmitter channel knowledge in spatial multiplexing technique. So, the singular value decomposition of the channel matrix H can be written as channel matrix H equal to U sigma complex conjugate of V. Here U and V are unitary matrix and sigma is a diagonal matrix of singular values. Okay, next let us consider a block diagram which represents a MIMO system that has been diagonalized through SVD pre-coding. Here input data stream, it is divided into parallel substreams. B represents symbol vector and this is applied as input to a system which multiplies unitary matrix V. Output of this system is X equal to V into B, where X is the transmit vector and H equal to U sigma V star. Here H refers to the channel matrix and sigma is the diagonal matrix of singular values. At the receiver section, Y is the receive vector. Here N is the noise vector, so Y equal to HX plus N and this is applied as input to a system which multiplies U star, that means complex conjugate of unitary matrix with Y. So, output of this system is U star Y and then it is applied to the decision device which estimates the symbol and that estimated symbol is represented as B cap. So, this B cap, it gives a estimated value. So, with linear operations at the transmitter and receiver, that is multiplying by V and U respectively, the channel can be diagonalized. Next, we can write the decision vector and in the systematic form, we can write it as D equal to U star Y, where Y is the received vector. So, this can be written as U star substitute for Y. So, HX plus N. So, U star into HX plus N. In the next step, substitute for capital H, that means channel matrix. So, we can write it as U star into U sigma V star V V plus N. So, here V star V and U star U are identity matrix. And in the next step, we can write it as sigma B plus U star N. So, clearly it shows that the singular value approach does not result in noise enhancement because U is a unitary matrix and U star N, it still has the same variance as that of noise vector N. Therefore, this singular value approach, it reduces the effect of noise and in open loop linear technique, there was noise enhancement, but here in the closed loop system, there is no noise enhancement. So, this is the biggest advantage. Also, in ML detector approach, in open loop system, MIMO system, we have seen that the iterative decoding method is more complex. But closed loop MIMO gives high performance at much lower complexity than the maximum likelihood detector. So, this is about spatial multiplexing technique. We have discussed both open loop and closed loop spatial multiplexing technique with different kind of detector. Thank you.